a consciousness
right
of God. But man can never make a picture or an image of the Holy Spirit.
And they playing loud as a
name of God. Man may not speak with carnal lips. With holy breath alone can a man pronounce the name. In vanity, men think they love the name of God. They speak it lightly and irreverently, and thus they are accursed. If men did know the sacred name and spoke it with unholy lips, they would not live to speak it once again. But God, in mercy, has not yet unveiled his name to those who cannot speak it with holy breath. But they who speak the substitute in either way are guilty in the sight of God, who say, you shall not take the name of God in vain. The number of the holy breath is seven, and God holds in his hands the sevens of time. In forming worlds, he rested on the seventh day, and every seventh day is set apart as Sabbath day for men. God says, the seventh is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. Remember it, and keep it holy set apart for works of holiness, that is, for works not of the selfish self, but for the universal self. Men may work for self upon the 6 days of the week, but on the Sabbath of the Lord, they must do not for self. This day is consecrated unto God, but man serves God by serving man. The seventh day is the Sabbath. Thou shalt remember it. Keep it holy. The Sabbath day is the day of the light of the law, thy God. In it thou shalt not work, but search the law, the kingdom of thy God, and all things shall be given unto thee. God is not false alone, for wisdom is his counterpart. When cherubim instructed man in wisdom ways, they say that wisdom is the mother of the race, and force is the father of the race. The man who honors the Almighty and omniscient God is blessed, and in the table of the law we read, pay homage to your father and mother of the race, that your days may be prolonged upon the land that they have given you. The letter of the law commands, you shall not kill, and he who kills must stand before the judgment seat. A person may desire to kill, yet